What's up, y'all? It's Trans Genius, and you tuned in once again to the famous Living Realm Network. So, man, when I heard this, I was just like, wow. Like, what else could happen in 2020? Like, that's just mind-blowing. Like, it's like every day when you wake up in 2020, it's some new news that you never would expect. But y'all already heard, man. You know, they suspect Tory Lanez of shooting Megan Thee Stallion. Tory Lanez, Daystar, Patterson shooting Megan Thee Stallion. Yeah, like I was just shocked. I mean, I was mind blown. Like, yo, something ain't right, man. Something is not right about this story. I don't care what nobody say. Yeah, I remember when it first came out. Y'all remember when it first came out? You know, Megan went live and was telling everybody that she had got shot or whatever. But the story, nobody really knew what truly happened. We just know that, you know, Tory Lanez was with her and all this and that. But now, it's like she done came out and just admitted that she was shot by him. So at this point, man, it's like really, really fishy now. So the fact of the matter is, they was in Hollywood Hills. I guess they was cruising around in an all-black SUV, all tinted window. You know them presidential SUVs. You done rode in one before. I done rode in one before. And these SUVs are very big. So, you know, they had four people in the car. It's supposed to have been Tory Lanez and Megan Thee Stallion and Megan Thee Stallion friend and a bodyguard. I think it was Tory Lanez bodyguard, but it was four people in the car. If y'all seen the footage on TMZ, they was in the middle of the street. Somebody called the police on them because they heard a gunshot or whatever. But they was in the middle of the street arguing in this SUV. Somebody called the police on them. Next thing you know, you see police behind the SUVs, like with the spotlight on them and everything, like a movie or something. Helicopter flying over with the spotlight down on the SUV. You know, ordering Tory Lanez to get out the car, lay down on the ground. And then you see Megan Thee Stallion get out the passenger, and you know, you can see blood dropping from her foot as she move around, like, or like listening to the police orders. He like, you know, move to the left, move to the right, hands up. And he ordering her to do all this moving. And at the same time, her foot is just leaking with blood. Like the helicopter, I was watching the helicopter or somebody's footage on their balcony or whatever, but it was still far away from where they was doing all this at. But you could literally see, like, every time, you know, every time they would tell her to move or whatever, you could see blood leaking from this woman's foot, yo. And I'm just thinking, like, it made me think about so much stuff with the police, man. And it's just like, yo, come on, the girl is shot. Y'all got a gun? Y'all got a phone call about somebody got shot. If you see somebody bleeding, she was the one that got shot. I don't know if the police couldn't see the blood leaking, you know, from where they was at, since they was on the street with the with Megan Thee Stallion. I don't know if they could see it, but you could definitely see the blood leaking from her ankle or her foot, you know, at the camera angle that I was watching it from. And it was big ass drops of blood. And so, you know, Megan Thee Stallion friend got out the back passenger seat behind Tory Lanez. Tory Lanez was the driver, but she got out last after Megan Thee Stallion had laid down on the ground, and she spread it out across, you know, the flow. They ordering her to do this, do that. She like, yo, I'm out. I'm good. I don't got nothing. But the thing that really blew my mind was, you know, they was asking the girl, is anybody else in the car? The last girl, they was asking the friend, was anybody else in the car? She like, no, ain't nobody else in the car. So it's supposed to have been a four person. So in my mind, I'm thinking like, where this bodyguard at? Where's this four person? So the whole story is just very mysterious, man. If you ask me personally, I can't necessarily say I know what happened. I don't know. It's just when you in a situation like that with all y'all in a car, you know, and nobody outside of y'all knows that y'all even in this SUV. Nobody even knew Megan Thee Stallion and Tory Lanez. It didn't even look like Tory Lanez from the view that I was watching the video footage. You know, it didn't even look like him. He had on some basketball shorts with no shirt. I don't even think he had on no shoes. Did he have on shoes? Did y'all see the video? I can't remember. But the dude had on shorts, no shirt, or nothing. Like, you couldn't tell that was Tory Lanez. Now, you know that could have been Megan Thee Stallion. She was big old booty, you know what I'm saying? Just moving around, legs looking like a horse. Like, yeah, that's Megan Thee Stallion right there. And her friend that got out the back seat, she was thick too. I'm just like, yo, that they got her. Yeah, that's Megan Thee Stallion friend right there. That's her girl. You know what I'm saying? And so, I don't know, man. It's just too much to the story, you know, for the simple fact that Megan Thee Stallion first came out and said she didn't admit that Tory Lanez had shot her, which was okay, that's cool. But then she come around later and is like, yeah, he shot her. And then you got Tory Lanez that's out here saying, no, I ain't shoot her. I never did it. Okay? And think about it. Like, if you shot somebody and you was guilty of it, it would weigh on your consciousness, not unless you're just a cold-blooded person. Like, you just a cold-blooded killer. You know what I mean? But it was reported that Tory Lanez was just still out having fun even after that incident. He was still out chilling or whatever. You see video footage of Casanova walking up to him. He's still out doing his thing, you know what I'm saying? And he was just basically, you know, he was just basically acting as though he was innocent. And even his daddy got on and stood up for him and said that, you know, my son is innocent. My son believes in God. I do not believe that Daystar did this a day in my life. He is not that type of person. So, man, y'all speak up, let your voice be heard, leave a comment below. I don't know what happened. I don't know. It came across my mind that Megan Thee Stallion probably shot herself on purpose. Bad business deal, just trying to get back at Tory. Or maybe Tory, you know what I'm saying, he got angry, upset because she, Megan Thee Stallion, being Megan Thee Stallion, and he just shot her in the ankle. Or maybe it was a fight in the car between Megan Thee Stallion and her friend. Or I don't know, man. Maybe the bodyguard somebody accidentally shot themselves. People accidentally shoot themselves all the time. Lil Wayne accidentally shot himself. So I don't know. I think it was just a bad business deal going bad. I mean, that's why I be trying to tell y'all music artists out there, man, y'all about to be careful going into this music industry, because it is not no joke no more. It's different nowadays. It ain't like you can just go in there and just be a creative artist and be like, oh, da-da, da-da, and like everything just be fine. Like, you just making music, people like you because you make it. Man, no, this is like gang wars. This is like gangs. This is like, you know what I'm saying? This is deep. Like, this, you can get your life taken away from you if you're a music artist nowadays. Like, if you don't know what you're doing, and you doing the bad business deal and stuff like that or whatever, you hanging with the wrong crowd, you got friends around you that's bad influences, man, people could take your life over this stuff, man. I just watching a video the other night where DaBaby was at one of his video shoots. It was a shootout that took place at the video shoot. Now, mind you, before that, he went to a video shoot with some people, came up and approached him and was like, you can't even shoot out here in our neighborhood. This is my city. That's what dude was telling the baby. So it's just like, yo, if you're going to be a music artist nowadays, man, you just about to be prayed up, man. It about to be your divine destiny, okay? Because honestly, I think a lot of people just getting into this because it's cool. You know, it's the most popular thing nowadays. Everybody want to be the next music artist, the big superstar or whatever. But look, Megan Thee Stallion, out of all the people that get shot, not a dude. Megan Thee Stallion, big old freak, gets shot in the foot by Tory Lanez? Or that's what they say happened? Or that's what she say happened? Come on, man. Y'all be the judge. Speak up, let your voice be heard. Leave a comment below. Hey, let me know how you think this whole story went down. I need y'all to really type out some paragraphs. I need y'all to let me know word for word what you think the scenario was. Do you think this was a bad business deal? Do you think Megan Thee Stallion was running her big old mouth? You know, or you think Tory Lanez actually turned into like a person that commit assault on a woman, a black woman? Like, I mean, was it a fight? What's going on? Speak up, let your voice be heard. Smash that thumbs up button if you're gonna comment below. I want to know what you think about Tory Lanez being suspected of shooting Megan Thee Stallion. It's all over the news. I'm Trenius Henderson. Hey, yo, make sure you subscribe to my channel by clicking my face icon. Click my face icon. Subscribe to my channel. I upload new videos every single day, 1,700 videos plus, all right? I'll see y'all in the next video. Peace.